this point that I started to realise what was happening to me. The violence, the insults, the gaslighting, the isolation from friends and family, his victim playing. It was like clear as day. I, Lejla Doughty, was a victim of domestic abuse. Can't do this.
It's been a while since I've sat in front of the camera and done this. And I want people to understand that the tears I have right now, that I'm fighting back. Therefore, that Lejla, the Lejla who told her story on her birthday, the Lejla who was thrown through a glass door, the Lejla who was strangled, the Lejla who was attacked when she was pregnant, the Lejla who was punched when she was holding her newborn baby. I look back on that time whilst I was with my abuser and I just want to hug me. I just want to sit down with me and I want her to know that none of it was her fault. That she is loved and she is worthy and she was never alone. She didn't understand the power that she had in her voice and her story, and she never understood how much the emotional abuse was truly affecting her, just as much as the violence was. I try really hard to talk about gaslighting on my page, to educate not just women who are victims and survivors of domestic abuse, but also the world, people who have never experienced domestic abuse in their lifetime, for them to truly grasp the insidious underlying nature of how perpetrators, abusers, get away with all of the behaviour that they put their victims through. For 8.5 years, I spent my life with a man that made me feel like every violent incident was my fault, was a result of something I had done because I pissed him off or I didn't give him a cooling period. I look back now and I think, how was I so blind to it? Why didn't I just leave? And just those questions alone are just full of shame and blame on me, myself, as a victim. How unfair on it is of me is it to talk about myself like that? So imagine how unfair it is for victims to hear that from other people. People who don't understand, people who have never been through domestic abuse ever a day in their life. To turn around to a woman and say, well, if it was that bad, why didn't you go? Why didn't you save yourself? Why didn't you call the police? Why didn't you take your children out of an abusive environment? Because it's not that easy. Because what you don't see is day after day when someone is constantly gaslighting you and making you feel like you're the crazy one, making you feel like it really was your fault.
I left. I never felt more alone and unheard like I did in that period after leaving. So I took to Instagram. I started making videos to raise awareness for domestic abuse by telling the world your survival stories. And now thousands of women come to my page daily because they feel like they finally have somewhere to go where they're heard and understood too. And the thing is, I can sit here and explain every violent incident to you, how it happened and how much it hurt. But the gaslighting and the mental abuse is the hardest thing to put into writing. And as a victim, you feel like no one will understand. And at times, I felt like my story doesn't matter either, because maybe it hasn't been violent enough. But those who have experienced it, they'll get it. And hopefully, they will be a part of my story that lands with another victim and a survivor out there who will now know that they're not alone. In time, with the rest of the community, I hope I can make people see that abuse isn't just physical. Abuse is verbal, emotional, coercive, financial, gaslighting, trauma bonds. Every push, every shove, every threat, every punch in the wall, every broken window, every damaged item are all acts of violence, and not a single one is ever okay or normal in any relationship that you have. Minimizing abuse is so dangerous. It's exactly how abuse escalates from insults to strangulations to scars for life. And it's how many women end up dead. One threat of violence is too many. Nothing can ever diminish what you went through and what you endured. Strength doesn't lie in not crying or hiding how you feel. Strength is saying that no matter how many times I break, I will always pick myself up and rise again and again and again.
What is it like to live with someone who, on a very regular basis, will make you feel worthless, make you feel like everything's your fault, or maybe it's all in your head and maybe you're the one who's exaggerating what's happening? I don't even really know how to explain it to you, because without being in the moment yourself, you probably will just never understand. But when someone gets deep into your brain and they tell you that you deserved it, that no one else will love you, that they are the best thing that's ever happened to you. If you hear the words, "No man will love you like I do. You are damaged goods. You made me do that. That was your fault. It's your anxiety that's put us in this position." Day in, day out. The feeling of worthlessness is something that I just cannot quantify for you. But I felt that for 8.5 years. So much so that even when my life was in danger, with glass coming out of my arm and blood gushing out of it on Christmas Day, you could have stood in front of me and said, "Lejla, you are a victim of domestic abuse." And I would have said to you, no, I'm not. You've got it wrong. That was my fault. I made him do that. The level of emotional and mental abuse that has to take place for a victim to feel like that is catastrophic. It's every day. It doesn't just happen the first time you are punched in the face or pushed up against the wall or strangled. And I think what a lot of people don't realise is how much we minimise the acts of violence room. If someone punches the fridge, breaks an object in the room, that too is an act of violence. It doesn't have to be directed towards you and your body. Abusers are manipulative. They're calculating. They know what they're doing. They're very sophisticated in the way that they target you with the gaslighting. They've studied you day in, day out. They know how to make you feel like you're a rubbish mum, make you feel like you're a rubbish friend, a rubbish partner. And they will use it against you. So as a victim, if you are watching this, please do not sit there and minimise what you have been through in your abusive relationship. You didn't need to be punched. You didn't need to be slapped. One slap, one push, one shove is too many. All the emotional abuse that led up to that moment, that was more than enough. And you didn't deserve it. None of it was ever your fault. So please, ladies, don't ignore red flags. Please get help and get out. Please help women like me change the narrative for victims and survivors of domestic abuse.